Yesterday, I uploaded a video taking a look at the new PlayStation Store sale, and the Game Awards sale is fantastic, and right now, there are also a plethora of physical game deals. I know some of you guys are always gonna be more attuned with getting physical games rather than digital games, and I feel like I've been not covering those deals as much in recent months, but let's get back on that, and there are a ton of great deals available right now. Specifically today, a bunch of new deals went live, and some of them are absolutely ridiculous, so let's highlight a lot of them. We've got a PlayStation 4 Pro deal, and we've got a lot of deals on some of the biggest games at really, really great prices. So without further ado, let's get right into it. I want to kick things off with the PlayStation 4 Pro. I know some of you guys are in the market to get a PS4 Pro. I've said it often that I think the best case scenario is to wait until the PlayStation 5 comes out and then just pick that up, because it probably will be $400 or $500, and you're better off using the $300 that you would spend on the PS4 Pro on that console. However, there is the PlayStation 4 Pro 1TB Call of Duty Modern Warfare console bundle available for $298.99, so literally $299, and that is pretty good, all things considered. You have to value Call of Duty Modern Warfare as like a $40 game, and if you factor that in, that means you essentially get the console for $259, and $259 for a brand new PlayStation 4 Pro is pretty good. I know some of you guys don't even want to pick up Call of Duty Modern Warfare, but it is a pretty good game. I enjoyed the campaign. The multiplayer is your Call of Duty multiplayer, and you can have some fun with that. And I just wanted to mention that deal for those of you guys interested. All right, moving on from that, let's talk about just the PlayStation 4 game deals, because this is probably going to be up a lot more of your guys' alley. We've got a bunch of great deals on a plethora of PlayStation 4 games. Starting things off, I do want to note that For Honor Marching Fire Edition, yes, I know this might not be the game everybody is, you know, clamoring for, but it is down to just $5 on Newegg. That is absolutely insane. And considering that Newegg does offer free 3-day shipping with Newegg Premier, you can sign up for a free trial of that. $5 for For Honor Marching Fire Edition is pretty ridiculous, given that you get For Honor and you get the Marching Fire expansion. And For Honor is a pretty good game. I know some of you guys might have had a mixed reception towards it when it came out, what, back in early 2017? So it's been quite a while. However, Marching Fire does add quite a bit of content, and it does exemplify the experience quite a bit. And again, for just $5, this is a steal, and I thought that did warrant to mention. Alright, moving on from that, how about Marvel Spider-Man Game of the Year Edition for $15? So I mentioned this yesterday, it is down to $19.99 over on the PlayStation Store. However, for $14.99, this deal is ridiculous. This is the same price I believe Best Buy had the game for during Black Friday. It's Spider-Man, it's all of the DLC content through a voucher code. You need to remember that. It is not on disc, so if you get the game and you play through the game and you want to play through the DLC, you have to redeem the voucher code on your PSN account. So if you loan it to a friend or whatever the case may be, they won't get the DLC. Selling the game, you're essentially selling it at value of the regular base Spider-Man game. So that's a little bit of a bummer, but still, to get all of that content for $15 is tremendous. Want to also note that Gravity Rush 2 is discounted to $16 over on Best Buy. This is considerably cheaper on the PlayStation Store right now. It's available for $9.99. However, if you do want it physically, Gravity Rush 2 is often put on discount through physical means, so $16 for it I do think is a good buy. The game itself is excellent. I've talked highly about it multiple times, and please give Gravity Rush a chance. It's one of those games that I've always wanted another title to, but we're probably never gonna get another Gravity Rush game just because the games didn't perform all too well commercially. The first game released on the PlayStation Vita, the second game just didn't sell all too well. And I think Sony's gonna move on from Gravity Rush as a franchise. However, the two games that were released are excellent, and Gravity Rush 2 for $16 is a great buy. All right, GameStop's got some tremendous deals right now. The Outer Worlds is down to $38. It's $45 right now on the PlayStation Store. And Outer Worlds is a great game. It's a really good RPG done by Obsidian. And of course, I have to mention this over and over again. That price point of $38 is just a little bit hard to stomach, given that PC and Xbox players are playing it so cheap. They're signing up to Game Pass for $1 for 3 months, and they're getting to play through the entirety of this game. On the PlayStation 4, you gotta buy the game for full price, or in this case, $38, which is a good deal. I do expect that Outer Worlds is gonna be one of those games that drop in price rather quickly, just because you have to think about it from a logical standpoint. If Private Division was willing to offer this game through Game Pass, yes, I'm sure Microsoft offered a pretty penny for it, but they know they've marginalized the value of this game. You're already seeing it down to $38, and I wouldn't be all too surprised if we see it down south of $30 by, say, early 2020. Whatever the case may be, if you do want to play it, at $38, I do think it's a good buy. If we just forget about Game Pass for a second, forget about what other platforms are playing the game for, It's a good game and it's worth the $38, and it is a great RPG. Also, a couple other GameStop deals right now. The Division 2, yes, it's a game that at this point is 9 months old, but a 9 month old game should not be down to $12. And in the case of The Division 2, it is down to $12. A great buy on The Division 2, and Ubisoft has done a rather good job of keeping the game updated, adding fresh content. There's a lot to do in it. I know it's not perfect in every regard, but ultimately, I think if you do pick up The Division 2, if you give it some time, if you play it with a couple of friends as well, it is a quality title, and for just $12, you're getting so much content for your money. That's literally 80% off, and a game being 80% off the same year that it released in, the only other game that I can think of off the top of my head that had a discount like that is Anthem, and we all know the story of Anthem. However, in the case of The Division 2, I actually think it's a pretty good game, and for 12 bucks, it's a great buy. Also, do want to note that over on Newegg, Sekiro Shadows Die Twice is down to $25. This one, Game of the Year, as well as Action Game of the Year. Not really here to contend with that point. I think Sekiro Shadows Die Twice has as good of a claim as any other to win Game of the Year. I do think 2019, you know, I thought it was a pretty good year for game releases, but I don't feel like we had that standout runaway winner that in some years we did have. I felt like in 2018, God of War was like such a standout that it was hard to match that game. In 2017, we had The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. In 2016, we had Uncharted 4. I don't think 2019 brought forth with it a big budget title, a marketed game like those titles. However, Sekiro Shadows Die Twice was right below, in my opinion, of those games. I still thought it was a great game. It's an excellent action title from From Software. And it is down to $25 over on Newegg right now, so if you've yet to check out Sekiro Shadows Die Twice, now would be a great time to remedy that. Obviously, it's a From Software game, so you are going into it expecting more of a challenging game. However, nothing that is too ridiculous. I mean, if you go back to some of the older games on NES and Super Nintendo, these Souls games from From Software and their games that they do in general aren't quite as difficult as those titles. However, they are very challenging, but they're incredibly rewarding in the same token. Also on Newegg, Starlink Battle for Atlas Starter Pack. I just find this humorous. This is down to $5. I don't know if this came out last year or the year before that. I do think it was a 2018 release. But this was originally, what, $80, and a year later, or 2 years later, whatever it is, it hasn't been that long, it's down to $5, which is ridiculous. Obviously, the goal from Ubisoft was to make this game a real monetizable game where they could have kids buy toys and whatever the case may be. Really didn't work out from that standpoint. However, the game itself isn't terrible, and $5 for it, it's got some quirky elements that I do think you guys are going to be interested by. And again, when you're paying this kind of price, it's not the worst deal in the world. And lastly, Amazon does have Medieval, which just came out less than 2 months ago. It's down to $20. I already thought that Medieval was a great buy at the release price point of $30. I know that it got some mixed reviews. However, you have to assess this game for what it is. It's a remake of a game that a lot of people wanted to see make a comeback. However, it's not like it was this massive franchise. If you were a fan of Medieval, if you have that nostalgia attached to the series, you're gonna love this game. You're really gonna enjoy it. It has a lot of the quirkiness from the original title. It is a little bit dated in some regards. However, they do a good job in modernizing it as well. And for $20, I think it's a great buy. Had it been a full $59.99 release, or even $40 or $50, I could see why you would have some complaints. But at the release price point of $30 and now at $20, if you just want to relive it from a nostalgia standpoint, it is great. And if you do want to see what all the fuss is about Medieval, keep your mind open to it. Do not go into it expecting something completely blow away, as it is originally a game that released on the PlayStation 1 but remade for the PS4. So a lot of the quirky elements are retained, but overall I do think it's a great buy for $20. And that's gonna conclude this video. Again, a lot of great deals are popping up right now just because I think we're in the home stretch to Christmas, and a lot of these retailers do want to sell you some stuff. So stuff like For Honor Marching Fire Edition, Spider-Man, Gravity Rush 2, Outer Worlds, The Division 2, Sekiro, Starlink Battle for Atlas, Medieval as well. A lot of good stuff is available, and I would recommend a lot of it. But more than ever, I do recommend you guys to be a little bit selective with what you're picking up. I know a lot of you guys are amassing like ridiculous backlogs now. And you know, picking up a game like The Outer Worlds, that is going to be a rather big time investment, at least 30 to 40 hours. Even a game like For Honor Marching Fire Edition, that's a game you can get super invested into. Just be aware of the fact and be noting what games you're picking up, because obviously there's only so many hours in the day. So that's going to conclude this video. Sound off with all of your thoughts in the comments section down below. Thank you for watching, and goodbye. Hey guys, we hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, make sure to hit the subscribe button, and if you're already subscribed, do us a favor and hit the bell icon. This way you'll be notified whenever we post a new video. That's the best way to keep up with all of our uploads, and we usually try to upload 2 videos a day. And with the bell icon hit, you'll be notified whenever we do upload a video. As always, thanks for watching.